Hello everyone, myself Jyoti Mandala, working as Assistant Professor in GMR Institute of Technology. In this session, I'll be discussing about structure definition and how structure variables can be declared and how structure member elements can be initialized with values at runtime and at compile time using an example program. So before that, let's definition of a structure. A structure is defined as a collection of one or more elements of heterogeneous data types. Heterogeneous means different data types. Whereas coming to an array is collection of one or more elements of same data type. That is the difference between structure and an array. Whenever we want to define, syntax should be like this. The structure definition should start with a struct key and then the tag name, and then within this curly braces we need to declare all the member elements followed by the variable list and with a semicolon. Variable list, that the declaration of these variable list can be done in two ways. Here as an example I have considered student structure, where the student structure may consist of these following member elements and variables are declared using the syntax we have discussed, or else you can define the structure in the next statement. Using this statement you can declare the variables of your structure. Okay, now let us see example program how the elements, structure element values, can be initialized at runtime and at compile. As an example program I have considered employees, where the employee can be consisting of name, salary and age. So in the main function I have structure with these three: name, salary and age. Now as an example, I'm two employees, employee one and employee two. These are variables, right? Now for even I want to find the values. I want to initialize these three at compile time and for two and these three values at runtime. So whenever you want to initialize, then do that by using the assignment statement and within the list. So the first one is the name and the second one is the type and then the age. Now for which I want to initialize the values, and to do that we can use the scanf statement. So scanf statement, first I have initialized the value of name, and I want to initialize the value of the salary, and you want to initialize the value of the age. So these can be used to initialize the values of E2 at a time. Okay, next, after reading the values in my program, I have written the printf statement to display the employee E2 details. Now once the program is finished, we need to save the program with .d. Right? After writing, so storing, you have to compile the program. So for compile tab, and then we can use Alt+F9 shortcut or take this comp. So when there are any syntax displayed here, if no syntax errors are, we can proceed. Now once the program is come, we are ready to execute your program. Now remember, here for employee we need to give the values at the time here. So run, you can use a shortcut of Ctrl+F9. Right, so this is done. It is asking to enter the E2 name. So I am giving the name of Sita and the salary of 30,000, which should be a float type job 30. Now once these three element is the output, so A as an output, it is displaying the values of E1 these details. So this is offering the values at comp and run time. So this is how a structure value can be read at runtime. Thank you.